So just answering a couple more questions about the god of a street fighter or a real fighter's god. A god in Muay Thai or MMA, Muay Thai especially, is nice and high. When you get closer to somebody, you actually get a little bit closer because smaller in your guard, in your frame actually, because you want to protect yourself because those shots are a lot closer to you and it's going to be harder to read them. When you're further out in Muay Thai, we actually keep the hands up a little bit bigger because it's more intimidating. That's just one way of doing it. But, you know, in Kung Fu, for example, some of the Kung Tao styles as well will be closed off here to invite a round punch coming in so that you can get on the inside. That's just an applied strategy or a tactic. Another one is to be open like so to invite an oncoming straight because, you know, no one's going to try and go around that hand. You know, but you can set up things in terms of combatives. That's martial arts. What we do a lot also is combatives. You know, you can set up things by what you say or how you position yourself so that it will dictate their positioning as well. And I did this for a long time as a bouncer, as a doorman, and also in close protection work. So, you know, your guard in that sense when you're really fighting on the street shouldn't really be so much here, you know what I mean? Because that's an indicator. We talk about that a lot. I'm not going to rant about that too much. But I'm showing everyone that I have the intention to fight. He knows that I might be able to do something, so he might pull something and fucking stab me or shoot me or whatever. So really, your guard, in my honest opinion, is three things, not just the one, is your gestures and where your hands are at, like just using your hands here while you're talking with gestures and bam, I can fucking hit him from there, you know, with whatever I want to do. I can set up for any type of strike or combo, whatever you want to do. It's just, it's not what you do, it's how you do it. The other thing is where you look, just looking around, being on guard. That's a huge deterrent in itself, something that I say all the time. The other thing is, fuck off! You know, your voice. You know, I said that, I did that the other night, just like this, halfway through a normal conversation, just like that, with a normal tone of voice, then fuck off! Like all of a sudden my students were like, fuck! You know, nearly shit their pants. But even that in itself is a huge deterrent because I've done that running into fights to stop them on the door, as I said. Oh fuck, you know, like they get scared, or you just say stop, and you know, since we've been born, you know, since we were kids, green is go, red is stop, stop it, like that. It's worked for me before, I've said that a ton of times. The other thing is, you know, once you start hitting somebody, and they realize that they're in an immense amount of pain, they want to stop that. So if you say, get back, or drop the weapon, as we do is we put in commands while we're training with our combatives especially. If they can do something to stop you from doing what you're doing and you're giving them an easy way out, they often take that. You know what I mean? That's just in my experience. Sometimes, not all the time, pain equals compliance. So that's, in my honest opinion, what a real guard is made up out of. That's what the, you know, in terms of martial arts, it's applied strategy and it's all this thing, but there's a lot of thinking that goes into that shit. And what if it doesn't go your way? You know, you've got to have more options. So some people say, well, we do it this way in our Kung Fu. I'm like, well, if we do it that way and you do it this way, now you've got two or three or four or five ways. You know, so train as many ways as you can. In our combatives, we'll train from here, we'll strike from here, do all of our shit from, you know, this position. I'm just doing one combo, like a straight shot, a hammer fist or a clinch, a half clinch, bouncing off my shoulder even. Doesn't fucking matter, you know, as long as I hit that guy. And if I get into here and I start controlling him, I can scan, see where his mates are, fucking bust his nose on my shoulder or elbow, whatever you want. You know, people say, what if, what if, what if? They say, what if he does this? What if I do that? Or in this position, I could do this? Yeah, if I fucking let you. Do I look like I'm gonna let you? Hell fucking no. You know, read the shirt, idiot. You know, so anyways, make sure you check out yojimbofightgear.com for the sickest dojo swag out. Our online learning center, rawcombat.com, for a free week-long trial, and our DVDs, therawcombatshop.com, where you can get a whole bunch of this stuff and learn it from a long-distance program. So anyways, I hope that answers our questions, and just understand that, you know, I don't encourage violence. I think you should understand it and only ever use it as a last resort.